Everyone, thank you so much for having me here. I would like to congratulate UNICEF, Usha Ji, for all the efforts and hard work that they're putting into the betterment of children, especially because, you know, children are the future of our country, and the sooner we understand it and the sooner we make them understand it, I think they already know, but somehow in our country, and I don't know if in general, somehow when you're a child, you're like, the grown-ups somehow have this notion that bachcha hai, thodi samajh mein aata hai, you know, all those things. But somehow the generation that we're living in, the kids have become just so smart. They exactly know what they want to do with themselves, their lives, and how they want to go about it. Whether, you know, the child belongs from a privileged family or from an underprivileged family. I mean, every child is so intelligent now, and they exactly know how to, you know, go ahead with their lives. And thank you for the compliment. I think the biggest challenge that we all are facing nowadays is nobody has the time, sadly. Even in families, you know, I mean, I have seen this with my own friends. I would not want to name them. They've become mothers newly. I mean, their babies are now 2-year-old, 3-year-old. But the upbringing is just completely different from what we went through. I mean, somehow we feel that now we are in a more progressive state of our life, and generations are and things are so amazing. We have technology, digital world, and everything. But somehow that is just making the future generation, I don't know, a lot weaker. They don't, because everything is on social media. Everything is on their phone. Everything is digital. Parents, just to escape that whole responsibility that they need to actually sit with their child and communicate with them, the easiest escape is just give them a phone and they're going to be taking care of everything, you know. I mean, no. When we were kids, our parents, some of us got beaten up to be taught the right way. Now, fortunately, kids are not being beaten up, but somehow I feel that is... they're just taking that for... I'm not in the favor of beating kids up. Please don't get me wrong here.
Sorry, you have people listening.
Yeah, but you know, it's the parents who need to put in that effort, because everybody is complaining that life has become so difficult and so busy and this and that. But hello, this is your own child. You need to put efforts. You need to have the time to at least sit and interact with your own child, rather than just handing over a phone to that child and so that you can escape your responsibilities and do whatever the hell you want. So I think first, most important is communication, which a lot of houses, a lot of families are now lacking, because everybody is just so busy on their phones and busy in the digital world, in this you know, world which I don't even think is real. It's just a make-believe world. We need that time when earlier we all used to sit together for lunches and dinners and have interactions over the table and talk about so many things happening in life. But right now, even if we're sitting together, we're on the phone. So the whole point is to sit and communicate. I mean, and once you communicate, now the generations are even more smarter. You can have that freedom of communicating with them openly without having any hesitation. So, and if you don't communicate, they are going to go on Google, on the internet, and find out something which might or might not, might be right or might not be right. So it's better that you talk to your kids on your own rather than feeling ashamed or hesitation about anything.
Fabulous. Thank you so much. First of all, I must thank you, Zareen, for standing there. You do. So thank you. Thank you for actually embodying the fact that we need to stand up for what we when we speak up. Now that sitting down is bad. Standing up is great. Crazy. All right. So, you know, I think, again, actionable point. What Zareen says is give your kids time. It's not that...
Kid will also read a book with you.
Absolutely. You read a... Swati, are you capturing all of this? You want to create a more powerful future for your children? Read a book.
I would like to add something.
Sure, of course.
You know, this is what I've noticed. I want to add to what she said. We never ask our kids, what do you want? We just tell them, ye karo, yehi karna, aise hoga, aise nahi hoga. Because this is what we've been taught. Meri maa ne bola, aise baitho. This is what we are teaching our kids. We don't give them the right to think. and that's very important. We should give them the right to think. Unko sochne ka mauka dijiye. Unko kya karna hai uska mauka dijiye. Unko kya cheez kaise karni hai uska mauka dijiye. Hum nahi dete. We just tell them yahi hona hai aur yahi hoga. So I think this is also a very 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 important point.
Thank you, Ryan. Thank you so much. You know, I've been standing around and eavesdropping on conversations because that's part of the job. And I heard Rela introduce herself and people are chatting over here and they said, what do you do? What do you do? Any moms in the room? We've all done it. We've all done it. we'll try not to do it. And when Rela did this whole thing right now, I was speaking to him. And he said, the environment is not my fight, Mama. And I was a little saddened by it. I said, sir, how can you say that? How is the environment not your fight? He said, it's not my fight. I'm not saying it's not her fight. So I said, what is your fight, sir? He said, my fight is the children of war. There are children of war in the world. And there's this 18-year-old child who says, my work is for children who are struggling from war. And there are all these children that we don't see. How do you think, Sonali, media can play a role in bringing to light the struggles of children who are invisible? What can media do, Sonali? What can we do? What can filmmakers do? What can storytellers do?
This is a very unexpected question, and maybe I'll have to ponder upon that. But first of all, I would like to congratulate UNICEF for doing such a huge amount of work in India. It matters a lot to all the families, all the children, all the parents. And thank you, Gravitas, thank you, Usha ma'am, for being associated and having us here. Because I always feel there is some reason for us to be present somewhere. We are here together and we are getting to learn so much. I didn't come here to just share my thoughts, but I'm also getting to learn what all we are talking about and what is happening around. I've never given a thought to children who are invisible to us. I have always thought about children who are in my vicinity. I am a mother to an 8-year-old who will be 8 soon. And I've always been thinking about the emotional world that these children have, the metro children have. I have been very sensitive, possessive. I am trying to learn and unlearn a lot of things, trying to grow up with my daughter, because we are never born a good parent. We learn along with our children. So I think UNICEF is not adding to the children of the world, but also the parenthood of the world, which is what matters, because being a parent does not mean you should have a child. I think I was a parent right from my childhood. My mother ran a daycare center and I was her chief assistant. She would tell me hundreds of things that Sonali, ye karo, wo kaam karo, and I would assist her. There are times when I have held an unwell child from our daycare center for hours. I have told stories to someone. I have, you know, helped someone eat. So I have been mother to all those children, like Gracie has been mothering 400 children. And I at times used to feel that, you know, I'm too young to understand that the child is unwell, and I would still help. But now that I am a mother myself, it is helping me, and it does add while you are growing up. What I have observed with my daughter and the generation of, I mean her generation, is as Zareen pointed out, parents are busy. But they are not too busy. They definitely want to share their wealth with their parents, which is absolutely not needed. They want to flaunt that, you know, we have these brands at home. We have these cars, we have these phones, we have these XYZ things. And we have Alexas, so everything is at your, you know, you say it and it will happen. But at the same time, parents are in a hurry to teach their kids a lot many skill sets. If I see my daughter's friends, they are busy attending classes. They have dance class, they have music class, they have maths class. They have variety of classes. They have self-protection, judo, karate class, but they have a class. They always are sent somewhere so that the parent is assured by the time I am back from the office, the child is busy somewhere. But I don't think families are sparing time to share something really important which Gravitas is working upon is what is a good touch and a bad touch. It is very important for children to know what is a good touch and a bad touch. We never spend time talking to our children what happened. We always want our child to win the case. Case in the sense that situation, that small conflict or fight.
Sure.
We always want the child to go and say ki meri koi galti nahi thi. But we never try to understand what did happen. Something must have happened at the school. There was a, I want to change names in the next episode that I want to share. But you have to be very, very sensitive citizen.